Yup.
Yo. It's your boy once again, Matthews. Today, I'm in the village of Buryati. Yeah, there is a republic called Buryati in Russia. And the name of the village is called Arshan. And before you continue watching, don't forget to subscribe, like, and ring that notification bell so that whenever I upload a new video, you'll be the first one to be notified. So today I've just taken a different angle. I just want to show you a village setup in Russia, how villages look in Russia. So this is the setup and how it looks. You can see the mountains there. It's very beautiful, and there it's a shop, a pharmacy. There is another shop, and this is a road. It is tired. That's the most fascinating thing. To be honest with you guys, when I visited some Russian villages, I was so amused. I was so flabbergasted. I was so discombobulated to see that villages in Russia, they've got all the necessary things. For example, you can talk of electricity, you can talk of nice schools, you can talk of like everything that you're going to find in the city. And I'm going to show you a restaurant. This is a restaurant, you see? This is the village. They even have a nice restaurant. They just sell different food. This is the building which is under construction. Let me try to go in and see what they are trying to construct here. Yeah, this is I don't know if it is going to be a house or a restaurant. It is built out of bricks. So here is everything. You can find houses made of wood and made of bricks like this one, because it is still under construction. Different houses. You can even see a tower for network. And let me take you to the post office. So in all the villages that I've visited in Russia, they've got post offices. And this is the Russian post. When I visited, or when I was planning to visit a village in Russia, I was thinking that no, it is a village. There is no network. There's nothing. That's what I was thinking, because that's the kind of villages that we have in Africa, I would say. And I was so shocked. But some of the villages, like some of the houses here, they are built with wood. You can see this one. It is made out of wood. It is normal life as usual. You can find nice cars here, even most expensive cars. And this is the road I was talking about. There is literally everything that you would need. You don't even need to go to the city. The only thing is, life here is kind of boring because there are less people, less activities. That's why people, they go to bigger cities. Otherwise, they've got everything. You can see that man standing there. He rents out homes to people who come to this place. And so this is the road. You can see the houses, the setup of houses. This one is also made out of bricks, small bricks, and the dog, it is normal life as usual. I will show you where I'm staying. This is the place where I'm staying. Now I'm going to get my things because I'm leaving this village today. So this is the house. It's a kind of, a hostel. And this is the house of the landlord. So just like almost every house has got a banya. And this is another house. Let me show you a banya. Mostly here, people in winter, because it is cold, they use wood to warm their houses. You know this thing called a chimney. So this is the setup, and most of the villages, they've got small gardens inside. So this is the garden, potatoes just everywhere. They even have another garden where they keep or grow tomatoes and cucumbers. Vegetables. This is the banya where you can enjoy yourself. And another one here. And this is a toilet. The toilet is kind of outside, so even in minus 30 or in minus 40, you will go there and you freeze when you are doing your toilet. This is the house where I'm staying. There are two beds, one and two. So this is the chimney where you put the wood that I showed you from outside to keep the room warm in winter. TV, table. It's a nice place. Kind of cheap. Places where they do massage. You can come for massage. They massage you. I'm just still showing you the houses and how the place looks like. Just a small house, wooden. See how nice it is. Let me check what they are building. Здравствуйте.
Здравствуйте.
Крутой дом.
Крутой дом.
Да. Спасибо. And this road is not tired. It is just gravel. So other roads are tired. Others are not. As usual, you can see the grasses. Before I forget, I would like to echo this that I've not yet visited a village in Russia where there is no electricity, where there is no running water. If you visited such a village in Russia, please do let me know by commenting so that I might go there and see for myself. They even have nice straight trees planted along the road. When you follow that road, it will lead you to the mountain. And this is a kiosk where they sell the famous street food, hot dog, shawarma, and boom. And there they sell coffee, takeaway. This is also a restaurant where you can buy traditional food, Buryati traditional food. This is a club. Wow, okay. So you can come here and enjoy yourself. You dance, you drink, it's all in one. I would say this village is not a village, but it's a village. they've got a market where you can buy different things. That is beer bank, hotel, and I've just brought you to the market I'm talking about. This is our market. Marketeers selling these things made out of wood. This is where you can wear and have. There are some monuments of Buddhism. Correct me if I'm wrong. There is this place. There is a person or some monument inside there. Another sculpture. Now I'm taking you to the, I think, the biggest monument that they have in this village. People, they even come here, others. So big. It looks like those things that I see in Indian movies. My own understanding, or in my opinion, a village is a place where you don't find internet, where you don't find electricity. But this place for me looks like it's a small city. Yeah. So I don't know what you think about that, or maybe just my mentality. Just go straight like that. There's even a nice chick there eating, making tattoos. So here the girl makes tattoo. You can see how it is eating. Yeah, it's nice. There it is written Policlinica, meaning this is a clinic for this village. They work from 9 until 17. Behind me you can see some of the abandoned buildings. They look so odd, though I've never been to Chernobyl. It looks like one of the buildings in Chernobyl from those videos that I've been watching on YouTube. Yeah, this is oh, I wish I could go inside, but I can't. It's very strange to find trash on the ground. Yeah, yeah. So there is even trash here. After walking under the scorching sun, I've decided to buy ice cream for myself. It's kind of hot here. The temperature is about plus 23 today. So it is Siberia Buryatia. And this is the ice cream I've bought. That is the transformer which generates, or which gives electricity to other, or to most of the houses. I've visited about more than 10 villages in Russia. All of them, they've got fences, wooden fence, or maybe made out of wood. I just don't know. Russian people, they like their privacy a lot. I have left the hostel where I was staying. Now I'm going to the bus station. I'm leaving the village. It was very enjoyable visiting this beautiful village, the nature. everything. So this is all I had for you today. I just wanted to show you the village setup in Russia or in Siberia. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. See you in the next video. And this is the bus that is taking me home.